Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me this afternoon is David Luxton from KWESST Micro Systems. David, great to see you. How are you?
Great to be back with you, Christine. I'm well, thank you.
That's good to hear. David, from my understanding, KWESST has developed a new system to counter what's called loitering munitions. Explain to us what that is.
Sure. Well, just for a bit of context, I know you know, but for your viewers, I mean, KWESST is a defense technology company with some high value, what's called next generation tactical systems for ground forces. That's a combination of many, many big programs in the U.S. defense community and NATO and NATO partners. And yeah, just 2 days ago on Tuesday, we announced a new system to counter a form of weaponized drones known as loitering munitions. Now, I know that sounds like something that maybe hangs around at the mall, but it's actually something pretty serious and deadly, not a household word to most people today. But inside military circles, there's great concern about this threat. In fact, it's been described by some military analysts as, quote, nothing less than a revolution in land warfare. So what you ask, what are loitering munitions? Well, they're, first of all, unlike conventional drone threats, they're programmed or they're guided to fly straight to a target area for surveillance or to attack with improvised explosives. A loitering munition, by contrast, much more sophisticated. It can be very small or the size of a surfboard. And it is a military grade autonomous suicide or kamikaze drone with a built-in warhead and sensors of various kinds that can detect, locate targets on the ground. So it can hover in a target area for extended periods, sometimes for hours, to search for targets. Then it attacks selectively with great precision and autonomously once a desired target is located. So that kind of paints the picture of what this is, I hope. And so you can, in a way, think of loitering munitions as a very effective poor man's guided missile, because they're much less expensive than a guided missile. And these are now playing really a decisive role in conflict zones in the world. One widely reported example was the conflict between Armenia and Azerbaijan in the Nagorno-Karabakh area. And so those who follow those kind of conflicts know that this was really a turning point in terms of the kind of effect, decisive effect, that loitering munitions can have. So that's what a loitering munition is.
So what's the technology that KWESST has developed to help try and counter that?
So I'm going to be a little bit coy here, right, for security and competitive reasons, but we've proven out the feasibility of a technology that we believe can be very effective countermeasure, not only against loitering munitions, but against these other conventional small drone threats as well. Now, the details of that, exactly how it does that are confidential for the moment for security and competitive reasons. But in concept, the system receives a signal from any third-party drone detection system, right? There's lots of them out there. And that will locate and track the loitering munition. Then our system launches an unmanned platform with our proprietary non-explosive payload into the flight path of the loitering munition, right? To neutralize it and prevent it from completing its mission. And because of the method of neutralization is non-explosive, the system can also be safely used against domestic drone threats. For example, it's sensitive facilities, public events, and so on, with minimum risk of collateral damage. So it's a dual purpose system that we think the market will find very compelling. And we've partnered with a leading U.S. drone engineering company, again, for security reasons, we won't say who, in order to carry out our neutralizing payload. And together, we've successfully now completed the feasibility phase. And we're announcing this because we've now begun work to produce functioning demonstration units for early 2022, with plans for trials with U.S. military agencies in the second quarter of 2022, and we've had engagement for some time on these kinds of drone threats with U.S. military and other militaries. So that's the roadmap from here to there.
So there is quite a bit of interest from U.S. military.
Well, yeah, we're already engaged with the U.S. military on with white papers and other types of solutions we've been working on, and so we're not an unknown quantity. But this is a world market and a world opportunity because everybody is concerned about how do we stop this threat that, as I say, the military community has said is nothing less than a revolution in land warfare.
It's very powerful words there, and appreciate the details that you could give us there. David, thanks so much for the time.
Well, more to follow. Thanks for your interest, Christine.